Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I think I'm the last speaker of this parliament for tonight, but representing Janubi Punjab, I'll try to do my best. Mr. Speaker, before I start, I would like to add that I am the fourth generation to be part of this honorable parliament. I have seen my grandfather here. My father, Chaudhry Jafar Iqbal, has been sitting on the chair you're sitting as a speaker. And I have seen very notable, honorable leaders to be were part of this house. Nawaz Sharif Sahab as the Prime Minister, Benazir Bhutto as the leader of the opposition. But we never saw the chaos, the lunatism we saw the other day. Honest to God, I was embarrassed. Because this house is the most prestigious house, the most honorable place. We strive to come here. We represent the community we come from. And we take thousands of votes to reach this parliament. This is the way to disgrace it. So for the coming years, I would request my member parliamentarians, for whatever time we have, we should show patience, endurance for each other, and love and respect for each other. For whoever will win, but this will not take us anywhere. Now, Mr. Speaker, before I start with the budget speech, I would like to quote the Finance Minister. He said, "Prime Minister Imran Khan wants to change the course of history." Of course he has changed the course of history. For bringing in 700 billion taxation, bringing a lower income support program for a person who has a very low income of 20,000 rupees under the taxation of 10 billion. How do you expect him to sustain and provide livelihood to his children, to provide shelter, to provide rent, to provide food, to provide medical facilities? I would like to ask the Finance Minister, for when he comes next time in this house, to please give us a breakup that how should that person live in those 20,000 rupees in this day and age. Mr. Speaker, it's easier said than done, but I'm sorry to say, ye kehte hai na safed hathi, sirf safed hathi ko yahan pe take care kiya, gareeb ko nahi, ye sirf lafzi jama kharch hai. Gareeb ki pasli todi gayi hai. Purane Pakistan mein, agar gareeb sota tha, to bhookhe pet nahi sota tha. Teen waqt ki roti zarur milti thi usse. Lekin aaj, ek waqt ki roti mushkil hai. Kabhi aap kharat, jahan batti hai, wahan jaake dekhe, kitni lambi queues hain. Ek waqt ki roti ke liye log jhadak ek dusre se nawale cheen rahe hote hain, rotiyon ke lifafe cheen rahe hote hain. It is very painful and very miserable. Mr. Speaker, industrial growth pe to baat ki, but what about human development? What about the youth of Pakistan? Pakistan is the second youngest country of South Asia after Afghanistan, and the population of the youth is above 64%. What has this new budget given for the youth of Pakistan? Any new programs? We provided them laptops. We gave them endowment funds. We gave them job facilities. But what has this government done? Aaj halat ye ho gaye hain ki log apne bache, they don't want to work in Pakistan. They'll disgrace themselves. They'll do a small scale job, but they'll try to go abroad. चाहे इलीगल तरीके से जाएं, कंटेनर्स में बंद होके क्या पता उधर जाके लाशें उनकी खुलें, लेकिन वो ये रिस्क लेते हैं, because they don't see promising Pakistan here. Why, Mr. Speaker? Why has this? It has come down to this. It pains me when I see a young master degree holder, young boy driving a rickshaw, and he says that I have no other choice to how to sustain myself. It really pains me. So, Mr. Speaker. European Union mein, America mein, I hope the Finance Ministry representatives taking this point, jab bahar ke logon ne financial support dete education mein, so why don't the banks of Pakistan provide student loans to these students? Yesterday I received a call from my constituency, a very elderly man crying. He said, beta, for the little money I had of my pension, I've married my daughters, but I don't have money to send my son to a university. What do I do? What answer should I give that what PTI government has done? It is very shameful. Mr. Speaker, we have come out of COVID, but there's a bigger challenge we have to face. The world is addressing it, but Pakistan is not as yet. Pakistan has to look into global warming, eco-friendly things. We haven't done anything for the recycling, for the ban of plastic. You know, Mr. Speaker, that 80 tons of plastic is thrown every year in the ocean. And we as human beings, we live because of the ocean. Because 50% of the oxygen we get is through the ocean. If the marine life dies, we die as human beings. When did we ever see that in June month there was a hailstorm, there was a snowfall? Isn't this awakening our eyes that we need to do something and address it? Yeh isi tarah hai jaisa COVID aaya tha, nobody believed. But when it hit us bad. So, Mr. Speaker, we need to address this now. Mr. Speaker, this is not the time of arms war. But we have a war with India. We might not, I hope, and we might not never go for nuclear war. But how do we free the Kashmiri people? I'm a member of Kashmir Committee and have come to realize that there is no set budget for the Kashmir. We have to educate the people. The other side of the world, that what is Kashmir, nobody knows. We are just fighting a war on our own. Aadi dunya ko to Kashmir ka naam hi nahi pata. Aur India apna point of view de raha hai. Hame chahiye ki hame apni facilities use karke, we need to educate the world what is happening in Kashmir. That is the way we are going to fight this war. There's no other way. Mr. Speaker, I belong to South Punjab. And I would like to talk about my suba. Yahan awaz di, Janubi Punjab bana ke denge. 3 saalon mein to kuch nahi hua. Koi khabar aayi aapko ki kuch hua hai Janubi Punjab ka? Ye sirf ek siyasi nara tha. Main puchna chahungi ki aaj ye bataye yahan pe baithe hue log ki Janubi Punjab ke liye kya kiya. Main apne qaid Mian Mohammad Nawaz Sharif ne kya kiya bataungi. Main bataungi mera leader Shahbaz Sharif ne kya kiya. And I have a list of things. Just to educate this parliament that what they have they delivered. Bahuddin Zakaria University, Multan. Women College, Kader Peer. Women College, Muzaffargarh. Men College, Muhammad Nawaz Sharif University, Multan. Khwaja Farid Engineering University. Sir, these are not, you know, small projects, but they are a game changer. They are a game changer for the youth who cannot travel to a big city and to get educated, but they are getting facilitated. This is what my leader Nawaz Sharif did. This is what my leader Shahbaz Sharif did for South Punjab. And now, before I wind up, I would like to urge the government that South Punjab jo hai India mein nahi hai, Pulbhushan wahan ka rehne wala nahi hai, to khudara unko tawajjuh de. Unke baare mein soche. Hum representatives hain, hame funds nahi milte na sahi, lekin khudara un logon ka puchhein. Koi aisi scheme nahi hui jiske liye aap khaas taur pe own karne ke Janubi Punjab ko mili hai. Hepatitis se log mar rahe hain, lack of water se mar rahe hain, aur wahan pe jo halaat hain itni heat ke upar garmi se mar rahe hain. Agle din roadon ka ye haal hai ki main road pe ek pajaro bilkul zameen bos ho gayi kyunki wahan barish hui. Kabhi ye aapne waqia suna hai ki itni badi gaadi zameen bos hogi main highway pe because of barish? Sir, it's high time we address ye jo narebazi victimization. Sab waqt guzar jayega, ye ek paiya hai. What goes around will come around. Nawaz Sharif dilon mein rehta hai, usko koi nahi mita sakta. Shahbaz Sharif dilon mein rehta hai, usko koi nahi mita sakta. Agar halal karni hai apni seat to inko kuch deliver karna padega. It's high time, sir. It's high time not to play the blame game. It's high time to deliver. Pakistan Zindabad.
Thank you very much. The house is adjourned to meet again.